Hello, good morning students. Yesterday we finished 6.1 exercise. Now we will discuss some more basic definitions. Then we will start our next exercise. First is, what is parallel lines? These word parallel lines we are hearing from the 6th class. What are parallel lines? So again I am repeating it. What is parallel lines? If two lines in a plane that never intersect to each other, then it is called a parallel lines. If two lines in a plane that never intersects, that never intersect each other is called parallel line. What is, if two lines never intersect each other in a plane, each other is called parallel lines. Example, suppose like this one. It is AB line. AB. And it is CD line. Yes. We know their lines are straight line and they are never meeting each other. It's mean other definition you can say that if perpendicular distance between any two lines is always same. Perpendicular distance. What is this? Perpendicular distance. This distance is also here. Everywhere is the same. If perpendicular distance is same between two lines, then these are called parallel lines. Understand? If two lines are never intersect each other. Next is, it is also we already discussed in 7th class. What is transversal line? Transversal line. Can anyone tell me what is transversal line? Think 5 seconds and then tell me what is transversal line. What is transversal line? A line which intersect, a line which intersects two or more lines at distinct. What is distinct mean? Different. Two or more lines at distinct point is called transversal line. Note down it. Suppose it is one line and it is one line. AB line and suppose it is CD line. If a line which intersect, yes, it is line. MN. Yes. MN line. A line. A line which intersect two or more line. Yes, you can see that MN line is intersect. This cut the two lines AB and CD at a distant point. Yes, one point is this one and one is two point is called. So it is a transversal line. It is slant line will be called transversal line, and which cut different two point, two or more points or two or more lines. Understand? It is transversal line. So it is very important. What is trans? Most of every question here is given in 6.2. Transversal line means a line which cuts two or more lines at different points. Understand it? Next is, yes, are you recognize something when you observing of this picture? Yes, दिस वन यू ऑलरेडी स्टडी, दे आर डिफरेंट एंगल्स. एट एंगल, टू लाइन्स आर व्हेन कट बाय ट्रांसवर्स लाइन, हाउ मेनी एंगल्स आर मेक? एंगल ए एट, वन, एंगल टू, एंगल थ्री, एंगल फोर, एंगल फाइव, एंगल सिक्स, एंगल इट इज सेवन एंगल, इट इज सेवन एंगल, इट इज एट एंगल. हाउ मेनी डिफरेंट एंगल्स? एंगल देर आर एट एंगल्स एंड बोथ आर, यू कैन चेक इट, दे आर सम इंटीरियर एंगल, सम आर एक्सटीरियर एंगल. दोज एंगल्स आर आउटसाइड द लाइन्स, या आउटसाइड इट्स कॉल्ड एक्सटीरियर एंगल. एंगल वन, एंगल टू, एंगल सेवन एंड एंगल एट आर एक्सटीरियर एंगल एंड सम आर इंटीरियर एंगल. दोज आर इनसाइड द लाइन, इनसाइड, तो इट्स मीन इनसाइड. एंगल थ्री, सिक्स, फाइव एंड फोर आर इंटीरियर एंगल. देर आर एट एंगल्स, फोर आर एक्सटीरियर एंगल एंड फोर आर इंटीरियर एंगल. एंड एवरी वन नो, वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन सेवंथ क्लास व्हाट इज कोरस्पेंडिंग एंगल्स, व्हाट इज अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल, व्हाट इज एक्सटीरियर एंगल, व्हाट इज इंटीरियर एंगल ऑन सेम साइड. तो फर्स्ट इज कोरस्पेंडिंग एंगल्स, कोरस्पोंडिंग एंगल. Do you remember? I told you in 7th class, what is corresponding angle? Corresponding angles mean those angles are which are on same position. What is? That means angle 1 equal to corresponding angle 5. Yes, angle 1 and 5. You can check it. Angle 1 R is upside of the AB line and but left. It is also on upside and left. That means both are on same position. Angle 2 and 6 are corresponding, yes. They are right side and upside. Angle 4 and 8. Angle 3 and 7. They are very important formulas. So, angle 3 equal to angle 7. No one you will tell you again in 10th class. Now you have to should remember. And we will use in 10th class also. So these are the corresponding angles. Next is alternate interior. Interior mean inside. Alternate interior angles. Interior. So first we are here discussing only interior. And which one? Alternate. And alternate I already told you in 8th class. We will use by 7th class. By Z. It means one is left side, one is right side. Alternate. One left, one right. It means it is. Because it is, can check it. By Z. Angle 4 and angle 6. Only interior angle we are discussing. Interior. Angle 4 equal to angle 6. One is left, one is right. So angle 4 equal to angle 6. Next is angle 3 equal to angle 5. Do you understand? Same as it is. Alternate exterior angle. Exterior angle. Now we are discussing only exterior. What are exterior? Angle 1 equal to angle 7. Yes, 1 is left, 1 is right. Angle 1 and 7. Angle 2 and 8. Now is D. Now interior angle. Interior angles on same side of transversal line or transversal. Understand it? Yes. Next is interior angles. Interior, which one are interior angle but on same side? Yes. Angle 4 and 5. Always remember sum of interior angle on same side. Again, listen to me carefully. Interior angle on same side. 4 and 5, same side, 3 and 7. ऑलवेज सम इज 180. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अदरवाइज यू कैन राइट विच वन आर द एंगल फॉर एंगल फॉर एंड एंगल फॉर एंड एंगल फॉर एंड एंगल फाइव एंड कॉमा एंगल थ्री एंड एंगल सिक्स. तो रिमेंबर दीज आर. तो फर्स्ट नोट डाउन इट. व्हाट इज कोरस्पेंडिंग एंगल, व्हाट इज अल्टरनेटिंग ट्रायंगल एंड व्हाट इज एंड. यू कैन राइट हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ इक्वल साइन एंड. अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन आल्सो राइट. तो नोट डाउन इट. व्हाट इज कोरस्पेंडिंग एंगल, व्हाट इज अल्टरनेट, व्हाट इज इंटीरियर एंगल. Now I am telling you some important thing. What is it? Is if a transversal, if a transversal line intersect two parallel lines, then what happen? If a transversal line whose cut intersect two parallel line. In first case, we don't discuss they are parallel or not. We don't know. Dekho, it is maybe like this one. These two lines are, these are not parallel, but it is also transversal line. And if these two are parallel, then it is also a transversal line. So we are discussing when these two lines are parallel and cut by transversal line. We are not discussing this case. Now, so take two parallel lines. I am saying when two parallel lines are intersect by a transversal line, then what happen? First case, then corresponding angles are always equal. Angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. What is the case? Each pair of corresponding angles is equal. Which one are corresponding? Angle 1 equal to angle 5. Yes, each pair. And angle 2 equal to 6. Angle 4 equal to angle 8. Angle 3 equal to angle 7. They are all always equal. If two parallel lines are cut by, intersect by a transversal line, then corresponding angles are equal. Same as it is. Each pair of alternate Interior angles is equal. Each pair of alternate interior. So angle 4 equal to angle 6 and angle 3 equal to angle 5. Do you understand? Next is, which one? Same as it is. Each pair of alternate exterior angle is also equal. Yes. Angle 3 equal to 5 and same as it is. Each pair of alternate exterior angle is also equal. Next is, each pair, which one is left? Each pair of interior angles on same side. Each alternate pair of alternate each pair of interior angle on same side of transversal line is supplementary. Supplementary you call, also you call sum of these two angles is 180. What is angle 4 plus angle 5 equal to 180, angle 3 equal to angle 6 equal to 180. These are all three property A, B, C are true, is true when a transversal line cut to parallel lines. If these two are parallel, only in what case? When these two are parallel lines. If a transversal line intersect whose? Two parallel lines. So note down it, it is very very important. Next is now we will discuss its opposite. What is opposite? Here first we discuss if two lines are parallel and cut by transversal, if two lines are parallel and cut by transversal line, then corresponding angle are equal, alternate interior angle are equal, and sum of interior angle on same side is 180. Now its opposite we are discussing. What if any two lines, we don't know they are parallel or not, we don't know they are parallel or not, may be parallel or not. If a transfer line cut the two any lines, if out of these three condition, out of three these condition any one is true, so we can say that these two lines are parallel, opposite. In first we discuss if lines are parallel, then alternate interior angle equal, corresponding angles equal, same alternate interior angle on same side is 180. Now opposite of this one, we don't know these lines are parallel or not. In what case you will say that these two lines are parallel? If either any one condition is satisfied. What? Either corresponding angle equal, then you can say that lines are parallel, or maybe you check alternate interior angle equal, then you can say that they are parallel, or third is sum of interior angle same side 180, then lines are parallel. So note down it, if a transversal line, if a transversal line intersects two lines, I'm not saying they are parallel or not, only I write here two lines, such that, it is meaning such that either, first case either corresponding, either each pair of corresponding equal, any one case, not only all corresponding, only one, each pair of corresponding angle is equal, either is equal, or you can say that, or second part, anyone, or mean anyone, either each pair of alternate interior corresponding, here you can write angles, alternate interior angles is equal, or third, sum of interior angle on same side of transversal line is 180. If a transversal line intersect two lines such that either each pair of corresponding angle equal or each pair of alternating angle equal or sum of internal angle is 180, then any one condition stop it, then the lines are parallel. What is? Then lines are parallel. So you have to remember this one. If any one case is satisfied, the lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. It is very easy. We already discussed in 8th and 7th class. I know. Next is last case. Then we will start our exercise. What is? First write lines which are, if any lines which are parallel, which are parallel to the same line, is same line are parallel to each other. What is saying? Lines which are parallel to same line. Suppose AB, if, so I am writing, if AB parallel to CD, suppose AB parallel to CD, and next case CD parallel to MN, yes. What I saying you? Lines which are parallel to same line, AB parallel to CD, MN parallel to CD, then are parallel to each other. Lines which are parallel to same lines are parallel to each other also. Yes. If two lines, AB is parallel to CD, MN is also parallel to CD, then lines are parallel to each other. Then AB is also parallel to MN. Because AM parallel to CD also. And MN is also parallel to CD. It means AB and MN is also parallel. But it's not a very, it's a very important result. You have to remember. We will use in the questions. Now, firstly, open your books and first question we are discussing. So in this chapter, what is vertical opposite angle we are discussed? Adjacent angle, linear pair. Sum of two adjacent angle is 180. It is a linear pair. Next, corresponding angle, alternate interior angle, sum of interior angle on same side, and what are parallel lines. Next is the question number 1, 6.2. Right, first, in figure 6.28, find the value x and y, then show that, we have given this figure, AB, and it is CD line, and it is a transversal line, yes, transfer. It is 50 degree given. It is x degrees given. It is 130 degree. It is y degree. Now, we have to find what is given. Given that, find value. Find x and y. First, we find x and y. Then, show that. We have to show that AB parallel to CD. Yes. Lines are not given parallel. You are saying, sir, they are looks like a parallel, but only look at the figure, you cannot say that they are parallel. We have to show that AB parallel to CD. And in what case you can say that two lines are parallel? If either alternate interior angle equal or corresponding angle equal or sum of interior angle is 180. Any one condition is satisfied, the lines are parallel. So we will check it. Which one proper? First find x. To write angle x plus 50 degree is how much? 180 degree. Why? It is a straight line and it is a ray. And which type? It is a linear pair. Sum of two adjacent angles. A straight line always 180. So it is, you can write linear pair. Do you understand? Because a straight line always 180. This angle plus this angle 180. So x equal to 180 minus 50. X equal to 130 degree. Yes. And we know y is also vector. If one is this line, this one, and one is this one. And when two lines intersect, vertical opposite, this one equal to this one. And this one equal to this one. So y equal to 130. Y vertical opposite angle. Vertical opposite angle. Y is also 130. X is also 130. X is also 130. Y is also. So it means alternate interior angle are equal. And if alternate interior angle are equal, then lines are parallel. Yes. If any one case is true, we can say that lines are parallel. You can write angle x equal to angle y or x value. X equal to y equal to 130 degree. So you can write what type of this type of angle? Angle x equal to y. So you can write alternate interior angle. So you should know what is alternate interior angle. What is correspond? So therefore AB line parallel to CD because alternate interior angle is equal. Do you understand it? So not done. Okay. Write it now. Second question. So everyone try first question I already discussed you. So you will watch the video and start your exercise 6.2. So example number 2. Now the question number 2 you will try yourself. Understand it? So thank you everyone. Have a nice day.